This is such a dizzying sort of phenomenon to keep up with, because one, you have to separate the president's tweets, which seem to be unending, from what actually is administration policy. And so of the tariffs that we have going into effect right now, I think it's hard to calculate the real value of them, because you also have to look at the reality. These are taxes being paid by American businesses, or in many cases, tariffs that are hurting American farmers and families. So I don't think you can only look at it as a one side of the ledger analysis. You have to look at it in totality. And
But Wolfit's question was, did you think that just the underlying premise from which the president starts, that we had to relook at the terms of trade, was that valid?
Well, I think, yes, all of us have done that. We did that in the Obama administration. We brought a very different approach to our trade relationships than we had before, utilizing the power to open markets, to give American exporters what they've asked for.
Which were you satisfied with those results?
Well, I think we were making great progress in that we were getting more access to other markets. We were getting more access and better treatment of American goods in China because of our joint efforts at the WTO and others. And there was more work to go. But I think there's a wide delta between the actions we've taken and not being completely satisfied, and just going to the very blunt tool of slapping tariffs on everything that comes into the United States, which seems to be this administration's only approach. To them, every problem is a nail and every answer is a hammer. And we know that's not the most thoughtful way to pursue this.
In your experience in working along these fronts, is there a way to get to a process with China to actually discuss some of the underlying issues at this point? What would it take, I guess, is the question, to get to that phase?
Well, it takes a multitude of formulas. And look, it didn't just start with us, but because this is both a problematic relationship, but the other side of that coin, it's a huge opportunity for the United States to expand our economic reach and grow jobs by, frankly, helping China meet some of their growth projections. China's going to add as many consumers over the next 20 years as we have people in the United States by a factor of two or three. That's a great opportunity for us to help them grow, to meet their needs. It's a huge opportunity for our farmers and our entrepreneurs. And so we utilized a number of formulas, from not only engaging them at the World Trade Organization, but through the Joint Commission on Commerce and Trade, the Strategic Economic Development, in which we had very blunt conversations with China about their more protectionist policies, how they needed to help create their own entrepreneurship by respecting and protecting intellectual property. And you can't, there's not one silver bullet. You have to do all of those things, and we were making progress on that.